Hello. Good morning, everybody. Happy, happy Friday, guys. I hope that your week has been good. And I hope all of you are okay and safe. Before we start, well, my name is Diana. I'm going to be giving this webinar today. We are going to talk about mailing campaigns, okay? Let me know, please, like every Friday, if you can see my screen, if you can see my cursor moving around, please. That way we can start. Actually, let me share my screen again. This one. Okay, can anybody please tell me? We have a chat window here and a Q&A tab or icon. If anybody can tell me, please, if you can see my screen, if you can see my cursor moving and everything, so that way we can start with today's webinar, okay? Let me see how many people are here. Can you guys hear me okay? Let me know, please, through the chat. I don't know if you can actually see my screen and my cursor. I'm scrolling down. Thank you. Thank you, Ray. Okay, excellent. Thank you, Craig. Okay, so let's start. Like I told you, my name is Diana. There on the chat icon, you can ask any questions. You can say, please stop, please repeat, whatever you need, okay? And I will repeat the information. So these webinars, like if some of you are new, are every Friday at 10 a.m. and we discuss different subjects every week, okay? Today's subject is going to be about the mailing campaigns, okay? No emails, but regular mail like letters or postcards. All of you have that ability through ReFX that is included in our three products, Platinum Hazard, Professional Hazard, and the Professional Dialer also have that ability, okay? So you just log in into your account. If you are already have logged in, click where it says account and then control panel. And the system should take you here, okay? In this case, this is my account. I have Professional Dialer. But we are going to speak about the mailing campaigns. So you can search for a lot of properties, and let's say that you are planning to do a little bit of wholesaling and you want to send letters to the homeowners, okay, to their addresses, either to the property address, to the owner address. You can maybe send a postcard with our delivery postcard service as well, okay? So the only thing that you need to do is actually find these properties, the properties that you want. So first of all, we are going to do a search. Whatever search is best for you, you can do that. So I'm going to enter my main product, ReFX Professional Dialer, and the system will take us here to the search area. Here on the search, you are going to find all the filters that you want to use. And that way you can find the results, okay? Now, I'm going to contact homeowners, okay? So people that are not on the market, because the properties that are in the market, they are with an agent, okay? You can also try to do searches for sale by owner. Remember that is a different type of data right here for sale by owner. But I'm going to contact like people that are not selling their homes, okay? So I leave the data here for public records. You can select any county that you want to, or zip code, or write down a zip code or a city. I'm going to look in the entire Miami-Dade County. I'm interested in doing wholesaling or buying properties that are single family, okay? So I select the type here. And I am interested in properties that are foreclosures, like pre-foreclosed properties, only that properties that have a lease pendants. So I'm going to select here foreclosure, pre-foreclosed. And because I know that the system is going to give me all the pre-foreclosures registered single family in Miami-Dade, I need to select a date, okay, for when these properties were notified, these owners were notified with a list pendants. So I go here and select inside the foreclosure filters. I'm going to select only from, I don't know, six months ago, approximately, okay? So I need to select equal or greater. Remember, this is like I'm saying since, because it's a date type of filter. So since a day 6 months ago, and let's go back maybe to June, okay, June 2020, until now, because I'm doing the search right now. So I have this part select. Now, how do I select the first part that was properties that are not on the market? That is inside the filters for public records. And right here, I have the filter that it says for sale, and I'm going to select the ones that it says for sale no, okay? Apart for having properties that are not in the market, I want to find like motivated sellers or maybe tired landlords, okay? People that haven't sold the properties in a while, in a few years, maybe they are interested in selling their properties, okay? If I find, like, let's say an owner that just bought the property like last year, maybe he's not interested in selling, okay? So for that, we can use the sold date filter, okay? So in this case, we are going to look for like backwards, like dates like a few years ago. And I'm going to use equal or less. Let's select, for example, and let's click here, and let's select people that haven't sold the properties, I don't know, since 2015, okay? So January, people that have at least like five, almost 6 years now, that they haven't sold the properties, okay? That's it. This is what I have. Apart from this, I also want to narrow my search for properties that have a specific market value, okay? I have a budget. I don't want to find properties here that have like that are really expensive for me because it's not my area, okay? I have my budget. So I can have or select a market value. If these properties are not listed for sale, I don't have a listing price. I don't have like whatever the owner is telling me. So I can narrow with a market value. Let's say that I only want to find properties that are, and I'm going to use between, I don't know, $10,000 up to $400,000, okay? That is my target, this type of properties. After I have selected my filters, okay, then I can do the search and I can see how many properties the system will give me. Let's try. Upper right on this icon is where you do the search. Remember, everything that is to your left, those are the different parts of REFAX, okay, of your account, the different access. And everything that you see at the top, those are the icons to execute any kind of action at the moment, okay? So let's do the search. Let's see how many results or records I can get. This many, 187 properties, okay? Every single one of these properties meet all the parameters that I select, okay? So I can start with this. This is especially for you users that only have either platinum or professional, okay? With the platinum or the professional, you don't have like the full owner information. You only have whatever has been registered by them on public records. So let's say that anybody, they didn't register a phone number. They never register emails. So the only way for you to contact them, okay, is by a mailing campaign, sending a letter or sending a postcard. Remember that you guys can always upgrade to the professional dialer. On the professional dialer, we have for you the skip trace tool. There you can skip trace and also use the social media report that in my case, in my account, I have it, okay? And that way you can find, or through the system, we can help you to find emails and phone numbers, including cell phone numbers for these owners, okay? That is with an skip trace tool that again is only included on the professional dialogue with a few other features, okay? Any question, guys, about the search that I did? Let me know, please. Let me see here, what are they? Okay, no questions so far. So let's continue. So I have 187 properties in my results, okay? Now, I want to do a mailing campaign to all of them. You can organize the pages right here at the top, 250 per page, and that way you will have less pages to select, okay? I have one page of four. Let's wait for this to load and I can see a question. How do we find the case number? The case number for the foreclosures? Sure, let me show you, Gabriel, before we move on. Now, remember that as soon as you do the search, the system will take you now to the results tab, okay? On the result, the system is always going to be open on the grid view right here, upper right, and it's only going to show you this template, the default template, okay? If you want to see more information than that the default template is showing you in these columns, then you need to create a different template, okay? For example, in my account, I have already created different templates, okay? And you can always watch the videos or just ask us how you can create a template and we can show you later, okay? You just click right there on this icon for open the grid template tab. In my case, I have one template with the foreclosure information and I just select and load. And now the display behind is changing to show me what is in the template that I have created. And right here I can see case number, file date. This is the day when the lease pendants became public, okay? When they were notified. How much is the known debt? If any of these properties are going for auction, you should see the date here and the auction amount. But remember, the search that I did was only for foreclosures for 6 months ago. So it's very rare that we find anybody that is going for auction after only 6 months, okay? They maybe do that after 1 year or something like that. So you can see everything that I have created on this template, you see? You just need to create one and actually see the full information here on display. But again, that is about other subject, about the results, okay? Let's go to the mailing campaigns now. You're welcome, Gabriel. Okay, let's continue. Now, how can I select all my properties? Okay, remember, you can organize the properties 200 per page. Then you will have either less pages to select or in my case, only one. Now I can select all of them. If I want to create a campaign with these properties, you just need to click right here at the top where it says mailing campaign, okay? And you can either, if like me, you already have some campaigns created, you can open the drop-down list. And right here, you can see the campaigns that you have created. For example, I have one campaign that I named Buying. This is in Hillsboro for Thai landlords. These are off-market, upside-down properties. But I want to create a new campaign. I don't want to add these properties to any of these. So you just click any other part of the system to close the drop-down list and click on new mailing campaign. And right here, you just put a name, okay, for that campaign. I'm going to call this one MV for Miami-Dade. And I'm going to select like this for, off-market and pre-foreclose. It's always helpful if you guys put like a date, okay? For when you have created this campaign. For example, what day is today? Sorry, it's Friday, bear with me. It's February 12th. So February 12th, and that way I know when I have created this campaign, okay? By any chance. So I put the name, whatever name you want to call the campaign, and then add the properties. It's really quick. As soon as the properties are inside the campaign, you will see a little notification telling you that they are there, okay? Let's wait. In my case, it takes a little bit longer. Might be my internet. Again, bear with me, sorry. It's Friday. Maybe the internet doesn't want to, I don't know, work. Can you guys tell me if you can still hear me, okay, please? I just want to check if it's my connection or if it's something else. Let's see if I have more questions. No more questions, okay. And now has over, okay? So the properties were successfully added to your mailing campaign. And then we click on okay. Excellent, thank you. Thank you, Mr. Nash. Okay, now, right here, I have already added all these properties into my mailing. If you refresh, and always please do not refresh right here at the top, okay, on the browser, refresh here. The system will let you know in this column, let's say that next week I do the same search again, or a search that contains this property, these properties. The system will show you these little mailboxes here, letting you know that these properties are inside a campaign, okay? Now, which campaign? That is something that we don't know, and the system doesn't correlate that here on this other tab, okay? In this tab, you have the campaigns organized by number, by names, okay? So this is the campaign that I created today. You can see how many properties you have inside each campaign when you created the campaign. When was the last time that you sent something? And I'm going to show you how these dates appears here, okay? And how many sendings or the number of send campaigns you have done. Again, I'm going to show you how that works. Excellent. So now that we are here on the mailing campaign, let's say, and let's start for, I want to create my own letter. I want to print my own letter. I want to print the labels, and I want to send everything from my end, okay? Not from ReFX. Because on ReFX, what you have is the option to send everything in a postcard, okay? But the postcard templates, it is already designed on those templates, you cannot modify it, okay? So let's say that you want to create your own letter. For that, the first thing that you need to do is go here to your left, okay, and click where it says templates. You will see that you have here different options to create your own templates. For example, email templates, okay, SMS templates, fax templates, letter templates, these are the ones that we are going to use today, task templates, these are for combo of tasks on the mailing, okay, and a script call type of templates. Now, let's go here to the letter template. You don't have anything created here if you haven't created a letter yet. So how can you create a letter? You just click on add right here at the top, and you start working on the body, okay, or whatever you want to say on this letter. Right here at the top, you just put a name so you can identify which letter is for what. For example, you can have letter for agents, for attorneys, for personal representative, for homeowners, and more. So this letter that I'm going to create is for homeowners, okay? So I'm going to call it contacting homeowners. Oops. Come on, work with me. Okay. I already, like, let's say that you already have an email or a letter already designed and you just want to paste it here. You can do that. Or you can start from scratch, from zero, and start writing whatever you want to say on the letter. Okay, you can say hello, whatever you want. You can always use the variables that are right here at the bottom, and you can auto populate for those properties, those 187 properties, auto-populate any information that you want. I will show you this in a minute, okay? I already have created my letter. It's right here at the top, okay? I have it in a Google sheet. So this is the letter that I want to paste right there. The normal right click, okay, works here. But on ReFX, if you try to right click, you cannot paste, okay? So what you need to do is with your keyboard, highlight everything, well, with your cursor, highlight everything first, and then with your keyboard, Control C, like Charlie, to copy. And then you go to ReFX, and here, locate the cursor, or, and then Control B, like Victor, to paste, okay? And that way you will have the letter or the text right there. Simple. Now, if I want to make this letter a little bit, let's say, personal, okay? And remember that the system doesn't allow you to change that much, okay? About, I don't know, the, what is it called? The alignment or, the, well, the alignment, yes. The, what's it called? The spaces between the lines, okay? This is a very simple type of format that you can create your letter. But let's say that I want to make it a little bit more personal because I'm contacting a homeowner, okay? So right here, I can modify or delete this and actually add whatever is the owner's name using the variables, okay? Right here at the bottom, just open the variables. And everything is organized by alphabetical order. So if I want to use the owner's name, I just add the variable, you see? Right there. Let's put this with a little bit of design. Good. So my name is Diana, and I want to buy your property or your house at, and let's use the variable right here for property address. Property address, okay, right here, property address. And maybe let's put also the city, okay? So property city. Good. Now, I am very interested since last week when I was around that area, if you have considered selling your home or for any reason, we should talk about, we should talk right away to determine if your, no, if my offer is the right one for you, okay? I will buy your property in as is conditions. Therefore, you will not be required to make any repairs or pay any realtor fees or other closing costs, okay? I will make it fast, simple, and easy for you to turn your property in for, yeah, for you to turn your property into cash. If this is in interest to you, then call me. And here I can add my number, like write it down, okay? Or you can also use the variables that are, they have your information already because you are a user pro ReFX. So sincerely, and I'm going to use right here at the bottom, my username, I'm going to put on a space after this one. I'm going to use my user last name. I'm going to use my email and my phone number or my number first. My number, and my number is right here at the top. You just need to go for the F, okay? And let's use, first of all, follow-up phone number, that is mine, and my email, follow-up email, okay? These variables, they are going to auto-populate my information, okay? Now, if you want to change the color or anything, okay, to make it more appealing, you can do that, okay? Simple, the same way that you have worked with, I don't know, a computer before, there you have it, okay? So this is my letter, it's done. I don't want to modify or add anything. I just click on save at the bottom left. And now I have added and created my template. Template successfully added. The only thing that is needed here to do is that you can select this template if you have a lot of them. select this one to be the default or the principal, okay? So you just select it here, put the start, and that's it. Now, this is the template that is always going to show on my mailings and as soon as I want to create the letter, okay? Now, I go to my mailing campaign, go back, and this is the campaign that we created, remember? So I click on it. I have all the properties organized right here. Again, I can select to have them only in one page, 250 per page, so I can see them like more easy, okay? All of them. Now, what I need to do is select them, okay? Actually, I'm not going to do it for a lot of them. There is a limit, okay? Try if your computer is not fast enough, if you have like a lot of tab opens in your browser, if you need more RAM memory in your computer, try maybe with 50 and then try with the other 50 and go like that, okay? Because it's going to take a while. How the system is going to create all those letters for all those properties. Now, I'm going to do it for one. Let me see if actually the page is like long enough or maybe it goes to a different page. So you just select one property or all of them and click right here at the top where it says mailing letters. This is the template for the letter that we created, remember? And now you just need to click right here, bottom left, where it says create letters. The system will open the file or download the file in your computer. If nothing happens, please check right here on the URL part of the system if you have like a warning. That is that you need to allow your pop-ups in your browser, okay? And try again. This is what it should happen. It should open in a new tab, a PDF file of the letter, okay? Oh my God, her name is like me. Good. So here is the letter. You see everything auto-populated. Hello, Diana, and it is the full name. There is not a way that the system can only take the first name of the owner. It is going to appear here exactly how the owner is registered on public records, okay? Using the variable that I show you, the variable for owner's name, okay? Let me show you this one. So if the owner is registered with 3, 4, 20 names, or if it's a company or whatever it is, it's going to show like that, okay? So hello, hope this letter find you okay. Right here, it auto-populate the address, okay, of her. My information was auto-populated as well. You can see it here. So that's it, this is the letter. And now I just need to print it, okay? Or download it to have the PDF downloaded in my computer if I want to print a bunch of them, okay? You can do the same thing, and let me close this. Let me select from here to here. Click at the top, again, mailing letters. Select the template, okay? Let's say that you have created different templates and this is the one that always appears. How can you change the template? At the bottom, click where it says manage template and you will see this drop-down list. It will show you all by like the names of the templates, letter templates that you have created, okay? Just select one and load it. Let's create these 5, 6 properties that I have selected. And let me show you again, the system is going to open in a new tab in your browser, a PDF, in this case with 6 pages because I have selected 6 properties, okay? So property number one or letter number one for this address, letter number two for this address, letter number three, letter number four, and letter number six, okay? Oh, more, sorry, 5 and 6. There you have it, okay? You see, Omar and Esther. That is how they appear on public records, so that is how we have it. Now that I have the letters again, you can download it, you can print it, okay? try to have maybe a PDF extension in your browser, like I have Adobe in like an extension in my browser. It's free, okay? And that's it. Now, how can I print the labels? I'm going to send these letters by my from my end, okay? So right here, click on labels, and you just need to select the type and the size of the label, especially if you have like stickers, the sticker sheets, okay? Check on the labels of those, what is the type number, and if you don't see it, you can just open here and select it. What is the size that you wanted, okay, that you wanted? The bigger one, we have only 8, 9, and 10. I'm going to put the bigger one. And you can also select where are you sending these letters? Are you sending them to the owner address, to the property address, to the attorney address, to the representative address, or to the contact address? If you have ad, if you have professional, and if you have ad, the properties also, not only to a mailing campaign, but to your follow-up, whatever is the first contact or the default contact of those properties, you can select it from here, okay? Now, I'm going to send this to the owners, okay? I didn't select, let's say, absentee owners, you can do it. I don't know if these people are actually living on those addresses. They might be living, I don't know, elsewhere. So I'm going to send the letters to them, okay? You can select the allegiance, if it's left or center. And this is like, we don't use it most of it, but you can select yes or no to the current resident of those properties, okay? Click on apply. And again, the system will either open or download in your computer the file, okay? In my case, it was downloaded. Now I open it and you can see it here. So the labels are there for every single one of them, names and addresses, okay? This is what happens when you use the owner address. If you use the property address, then no names are going to be right here at the top. It's only going to have the addresses, okay? But this is how it works. If you select to contact their personal representative, to contact the attorneys, they will have a name and also the full address below. Any question, guys, about how you can create a letter template? How can you print the letters and print the labels, please? Let me know. All good? Yes, no questions. Okay, so let's continue. So that is how you can do that part, okay? Let's say that I selected all my 187 properties today. I see someone that is raising their hand. Let me see. Mark, do you have a question? If you have a question, please go to the chat and just write it down, or through the Q&A icon and write down your question, okay? So I can see it and I can answer it. Let me know, okay? I don't see your question yet. I don't know if you... Sorry, I cannot see your question until you write it, okay? Okay, let's continue meanwhile. So that is how you can create your letters and how you can create your labels. You just select everything, okay? Click on mailing letters, then click on labels. Of course, you need to create the template first. Now, let's say that I did print all these letters and all the labels, okay? How can I like put a little note here that it was today that I sent everything? So click at the top where it says incremental counter, okay? Just one time for all of them. I have here, oh, okay, Mark. How often do I follow up after sending letters? Oh, Mark, sorry. I cannot answer that question. I don't work on real estate. I work on customer service on RealFX, so I can teach you how to use the system. But how often you are going to do something? I'm going to recommend to contact a realtor, or maybe if you are a mentor student, either from DRIA or from BRIA, just try to contact them and ask that, okay? I cannot advise you how often you can, I don't know, do that. It will be up to you, sorry. Okay, so here, the campaign incremented counter was already done, okay? So you can see that for all of them, I have here where it says number of times sent, one, okay? Because I have sent one these letters by my end. And when it was the date and the time right here for all of these properties, okay? You're welcome, Mark. Okay, so this is how it works inside one campaign that I have created, where I do everything. I create the letter, I send the letter, I keep up my follow-up, I do everything, okay? It's only from here where I can see that, okay? From here, you cannot add notes, you cannot add anything. The only thing that you can do is increment the counter or the last sentence, okay? That's it. Let's say that somebody replied, and actually was this one. Remember her name was like me, Diana. And she replied, she said, no, I'm not interested, okay? Or maybe she called me and look, I don't want to receive anything from you, I'm not interested. Okay, I go here and you can see that I only have the address, okay? So I can locate the address either by filtering, okay? With the property address keywords, either address, city, zip code, parcel ID, or when the property was last sent. And that's it. If I locate the property, I can select it and I can remove it from my mailing campaign. So that way, let's say next month, okay, in a month, if I'm going to do another sending, then I'm not going to select her and send something to her again. Everything done here is very, very manual, okay? That's it. Now you can also print this list if you want to print it. Okay, or if you want to print it, meaning download it into a PDF file, or download the Excel file from your mailing campaign. You can do that. Let's go back. And again, whenever you want to go back, don't click at the top on your browser on the go back arrow, click right here. Next to the greenhouse, you will see this arrow to go back to the last page. Good. Now we are going back to the mailing campaign and we are going to use the postcards. These are very simple. The system already gives you the design and whatever is inside these postcards, okay? So I'm going to use my campaign again. It has 187 properties. So I click right here at the top where it says postcards, and this is what the system will show you. The system, first of all, is going to let you decide which is the size of the template, okay? If you select a bigger size, and if this is the first time that you are using the templates, you need to pay a design fee. I'm going to show you that in a second. I have a question. Okay, in addition to see the number of times a campaign was sent, are you able to see a history of send dates? No, Reggie, you don't. Ray is asking, in addition to seeing the number of times a campaign was sent, are you able to see a history of send dates? Let me just close this. From the mailing campaign, inside the campaign by clicking on it, you cannot add any kind of notes or anything, okay? What you can do if it's next month, okay? Let's say that is next month. I do these six properties, I did another sending, so I increment the counter again. And then the system is going to tell me, okay, now you have sent twice, okay, these letters, and the last date it was sent right here, okay? You see, just a few minutes after, that's it. The mailing campaign is not a follow-up system. So that's why we always suggest you that whenever you do the searches, okay, not only add the properties to a mailing, but also add them to a follow-up, and then you will have them here. From here, you can add notes for all of these properties, priorities, or whatever you want from the follow-up, okay? And in the follow-up, you will have a history ready. Let me go really quick to my follow-up. These are all the properties that I have added previously in my follow-up, okay? And right here, if you click on any address, you go to the follow history, you can review everything that you have done, when and why. For example, February 9, I created a new offer price for this particular property right here, okay? If I add a note, it will be there. You can add notes from here and everything. For example, let's say that this property is in my mailing. And today I did a mailing. I sent a letter, today. That's it. Save the note and the note will be here, okay? Let me just refresh again. My internet is just crashing there. You see, today at this time, I made a note. If I go back to this property in a few weeks, then it's going to tell me exactly February 12th at this time, you made a note. Oh, the note was that I sent a letter today. That's it. That is how you can keep your history. That will be inside the follow-up, not inside the mailing campaigns, okay? It's completely different. Now, let's go back again. Select one property, and you can only select one campaign, okay? You cannot select three campaigns and do the postcards for all of them. It's only one at a time. So select one campaign, no matter the number that you have here added, okay? And click on postcards at the top. The system, again, is going to let you decide the size of the postcard, okay? If it's going to be bigger or less, or I don't know. The design template, you can have it here. For example, this is a first notice, a second notice, okay? You have different templates, a general mail, okay? This is a foreclosure pipe. And we also have, for example, a follow-up, okay? So whatever is the template that you decide to have, you can also decide when they are going to be sent. Now, we work with a company and it's called ShopSavvy, okay? That is the company that is going to send these postcards for you. So Sam Nielsen is the person to contact if you need, if you have any questions before a person seeing the delivery postcards, okay? Just contact him. You have here his email and his phone number. Just click at the bottom, right here where it says help, and you will see the information there. Now, the follow-up, you cannot modify the letters here. He will get your contact information, like your name, if the template needed, or your phone number from your account, okay? From your profile. I will show you exactly from where. So you can add that information into your account, okay? If you don't have it. Then you can select when the delivery is going to be made. Is always a day, Sam Nielsen, ShopSavvy, they need at least 1 week, okay, to send these letters. So the closest that you can select it is next Friday, okay? But if you want, just select, I don't know, I'm going to send this on March 1st. That is the day that I want these letters to be delivered. And again, you can select where are they going to be delivered. To the property address, sorry, to the owner address, to the property address, to the attorney. This is in case, again, if you're using probates, or again, for probates, the personal representative. That's it. You have your design fee here. The system will let you know exactly how much you need to pay, okay, for the sending. And if this is the first time, only the first time, choosing this postcard template, this one with this size, okay, they come together, then you need to pay a design fee for $50, okay? The system is already telling you exactly how much it is. But again, this $50 is only the first time. So the total send price is going to be this amount right here for all 186 properties that I have in my campaign, okay? Somebody raised their hand, let me see, it was Eldon. No, Eldon, you cannot design your own postcards. Sorry. And Reggie, please let me know if that my question was helpful. Sorry, my answer was helpful to you. And no, Eldon, as I told, you can only design your letter templates, okay? There you can decide what you want. You cannot add images on the letters, only text, okay? But these are not modified, okay? These are whatever and how they are is how they are going to be sent, okay? Let me know, Eldon, sorry, if that answered your question, please. Okay, now that you have selected everything here and you are right with these prices and everything, just click on checkout, okay? So let's say that I'm going to use the follow-up, okay? And the little size, because you can see, if I select a bigger size, the design fit, it will cost a little bit more, okay? So be aware of that. So I'm going to select this size. It will be the follow-up template. It will be sent on March, okay? To the owner. That is the design that I'm going to select for the postcard. Click on checkout right here at the bottom, and that's it. The system will store that information. You need to purchase or actually pay the delivery in 24 hours, okay? Because next day is going to be removed. You need to do the process again to selecting whatever you want and actually do it that day, okay? But here, you can also select several sendings, okay? Let's say that I'm going to do March, April, May, okay? Three sendings already scheduled for all of these properties, no matter what. So I go and add more, okay? So again, I select my postcard, I click on postcard again, I'm going to use this. I need to use the same design fit, the same postcard template and the same size. Okay. So I don't have to pay again the $50. So I click right here, follow up. That was the one that I used. I left the size for this one. And this is going to be the first one was here. So I'm going to do it on April 1st. And these are going to be, again, for the owner addresses, okay? You can select any other if you want to. And again, I click on checkout. Let's wait for this to load. You're welcome, Eldon. Okay. Again, it's Friday, guys. My computer, she doesn't want to work anymore. Okay, there it goes, you see? So I have one for March, one for April, okay? And I'm only paying the design fee the first time that I use this template, okay? And yes, it needs to be the same postcard template and the same size. Right here, you can see the detail for how much is the unit price, okay, per property. So that is what we are paying here. If you are ready to process the payments for your two deliveries, just click on process payment, okay? The system will actually take you here and let you, and it's going to ask you, do you want to use the credit card that is on file on your VFX account for this payment? Yes or no. If you want to use a different credit card, select no, and the system will take you here to put all the information. It's not going to be safe anywhere because we don't have access. It's only Sam Nielsen, Short Savvy, that is going to receive the payment that you did, okay, the notification. And that's it. You can pay through here. Now, let's say that I already pay for these two deliveries. So where I can see the status of those sendings? At the top, you click on postcards. And right here, you will have all of your campaigns, okay, that you can filter if you don't find anything. You can see the campaign name, the postcard size that you decide, the delivery address that you also decided, the postcard status. So if it was already sent, if it's processing, is it in delivering, if it's still active, like they haven't done anything, okay? You will see it here. Yes, Reggie, you have another question? Please let me know. And the creation date, the last update, everything will be here. You can see the total amount of your payment, when was already delivered, the postcard, and the PayPal ID, okay? That is how Sam Nielsen check your payments, okay? And again, the information is right here at the top. Click on Help Postcards, and you will see his contact information, so you can contact him at any time, okay? Reggie, did you have a question? Please let me know. You can put it on the chat or through the Q&A part of the system. I saw that you raised your hand. Let me know, okay? Now, meanwhile, the last thing that I wanted to show you today, we have a matrix of prices, okay? You can see that the prices are going, they are going to be less and less and less if you try to send more postcards, okay? What happened if cars come back, return to sender, are we notified? That is a question, Reggie, that you need to contact Sam Nielsen, okay? On Shop Savvy. Again, it is with him that you can check or verify everything about the postcards delivery, okay? So just contact him. He can answer that question before you purchase a postcard delivery or after, whenever you have, whenever you want. Just go there and contact him, okay? You're welcome. Okay, now let me show you really quick. I'm going to stop sharing to share this file right here. Allow me 1 second. Share, where is it? I cannot see it right here. So this is the matrix, okay, for the postcards delivery. So you can see that if you select a lot of properties, okay, more than the properties that I have selected, the prices per unit, they are going to be less each time, okay? If anybody wants to have this delivery, please, just let me know and I can send these prices to you by email as soon as we finish. And we are about to finish, okay? Now, does anybody have any questions? Please let me know. This is how you can work again, guys, with your letters, your own letters, with your own labels and send everything yourself through your end, okay, from your end, or how you can purchase our postcard delivery service with Shop Savvy, okay? I will send that matrix of prices to you, Jerry. Anybody else? You don't see no one else? Okay, so guys, thank you very much for having me today. Happy, happy Friday. Please take care of you, your family, your loved ones, everything. I will send that to you, Gabriel. Take care, okay? Crazy times we're living. Have a great day. Have a great weekend. Bye-bye, guys. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, Bernal, Gabriel, and Freddy. I will send that to you guys. Bye-bye.